That's my prayer. Can we close our eyes, please? Lord, this is our prayer, O God, that our eyes will be opened, our hearts will be opened, O God. And Lord, we will be ushered into a new dimension of calling. I pray, God, that we will be changed, Lord God, and we will not be the same when we go home. And we believe, Lord God, that you are going to talk to each and everyone, and you are going to leave a message. You are going to plant a message in our hearts, God. Lord, renew our mind today. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's be seated, amen. Let's be seated. The title of this message is, This is Your Call. This is your call, okay? So, praise God. Actually po, if I can open up something to you, I am not accustomed to this kind of preaching. My preaching style is entirely different, okay? How do Pastor Rich preaches, okay? Or preach? I usually take 5 verses in the Bible and I expound on that. But I believe let us all go out of our comfort zone in order to bless somebody. Okay? Let us all go out of our comfort zone in order to bless somebody. And I want everyone to be a little bit participating and involving today, okay? Whenever you hear something which is amenable, say amen, okay? Amenable, okay? Something that you can say amen to, okay? So, I'll be preaching in English. If you don't understand my English, okay, translate for yourself because this is my goal, okay? That I should learn to preach in English, okay? Okay, in English, okay? But there will be some words will be spoken in Tagalog simply because I don't understand it in English, okay? But now, okay, if you're going to see your outline, okay, your outline, the first verse there is, we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love Him. And usually, we stop there, okay? Whenever we quote this verse, we usually quote it like this, okay? All things work together for the good for those who love Him. And we stop there. We stop there, okay? And the problem is, the verse is so good. Actually, it only means like this. Not all things in life are good. Okay? And sometimes if you will take the inventory, some things will really look bad. At kung medyo negative yung aura mo, okay? The negative will outnumber those who are positive. But God is saying, I will never waste a bad thing in your life. I am going to put it in my plan so that everything will work out together for the good. And maybe you are now experiencing a pain in your life. God is saying, I can take that and I can draw a bigger picture of that. And I can see you, my purpose for you, I can do all things for you, says God. Now, we often left out the last verse, okay? The last part of the verse says, we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose, okay? God is saying, all things work together for the good for those who love Him. But number two, to those who are called according to His purpose. Okay, if you have a ball pen, can you encircle the word purpose? Okay, and encircle the word called. Okay, and then you draw a line between them. Okay, because calling and purpose go together. Okay, if you will read the whole Bible, God has called us for a particular purpose. Calling and purpose usually go together. Okay, now the word called, okay, the Greek term for that is kaleo. Okay? Kaleo, okay? K-A-L-E-O. Okay? Kaleo, yun yung asawa ni Kakundring, okay? Kaleo, okay? Kaleo. K-A-L-E-O. Oh, okay, kaleo, okay, and that is the word called in Greek. Now, in Latin, the word called is vozare, okay, I don't speak these things, but I will speak, okay, you see, okay, where we get the word voice, okay, where we get the word vocation, Okay? Our vocation is the same as our calling. But actually, the problem with our culture right now, we minimized it with career and job. So we thought our calling is just to have the position you have in your company. But it goes deeper than that. And we will be talking about that today. Okay. Now, I will be giving you 8 things what you need to know about your calling. Okay? 8 things what you need to know about your calling. Okay? Number one, I want to say, you can write it down, my calling is a gift. And it is by God's grace. Okay? Your calling is a gift from God. If you are going to see the verse, it says here, He has saved us and called us to a holy life. Not because of anything we have done, but because of His own purpose and grace. God has called you into salvation, not just for you to be feeling happy, not just for you to feel good, but God has a purpose for your life. And you may want to ask me, Pastor, what is grace? Okay, grace is very simple. Grace is undeserved kindness. Okay, grace is God giving you what you need, not what we deserve. Because if God will give us what we deserve, we will not have anything. Because human beings, by tendency, we are all bad people. And our inclination is to do something bad. But praise God, because God is gracious. And He will not count all our unrighteousness. And still, God will give us a chance, a second chance, okay? That is called salvation. Now, our calling, okay? We are called to salvation, okay? And I am praying everyone here understands this. Now, you are called to live a holy life. Okay, you are called to live a holy life. Okay, you are called to salvation. Okay, praise God. Someone is coming. Yeah. Okay. And then I want to say this. It is not because of anything we have done. Okay, your calling is not depending on what you have done, what you can do, or what you cannot do. Your calling is entirely a result of the grace of God. Okay? That's one point I want to say this, okay? I want to say to you, your calling is a gift from God. Okay? Number two. And then, guys, it says here, you were called for His own purpose and grace. Okay, that gives us to number two. Number two po, okay? Number two, I am called for God's purpose. Okay? You are called for God's purpose. And gusto ko po mag-sorry. I want to say sorry to everyone if you are, because I will correct some of your thinking today. If you are thinking you are created for you, just for you to live a little selfless, selfish life, you are wrong. You are called for God's purpose. You are not called to any other purpose. Maybe you have a purpose for your life, a self-stated purpose. Maybe your spouse has a purpose for your life. Maybe your parents have a different purpose for your life, but nothing outgrows the purpose of God for you. You are born entirely for the purpose of God. God created you for God, and that is all you have to believe. God made you, and God made you for Him. Okay? God made you for Him. Sa Tagalog, okay? Ang Diyos po ang lumikha sa inyo. At nilikha po kayo ng Diyos para sa kanyang kaluwalhatian. Walang ibang rason kung bakit tayo nilikha, kundi para maluwalhati ang ating Diyos. Nilikha tayo ng Diyos sa ultimate purpose of glorifying Him. And maybe you have an own purpose. Okay, I want to be like this. I want to be, yes, okay, God understands that. But bottom line is, you are called to accomplish God's purpose for you. Amen? Okay, there's a story in the Bible. If you know, there is a guy named Abraham, and Abraham had a son. His son's name is Isaac. And Isaac had a twin, okay? Their names were Esau and Jacob. And you know the story, but I'll be giving you a background culturally in the Middle East, okay? The firstborn always gets everything, okay? And yung bunso parang praise God kasi nandiyan ka naman, okay? Pero the firstborn gets everything. Okay, they get the credit, they get all the inheritance, they get all everything, they get the love of the parents, all, okay. However, something occurred, okay? We must know that Esau was the firstborn, so he should be getting everything. But if we see this verse, okay, it says here, before the two boys were born, God told Rebekah, the older will serve the younger. This was before the boys had done anything good or bad. God said this so that the one chosen would be chosen because of God's own plan. He was chosen because he was the one God wanted to call, not because of anything he did. What do we get from this verse? We get from this verse that God calls people. And God chooses whom He wants to call. And I want to say this, you are listening to this message because you are called by God. God wanted to call each one of you. God wanted to express His calling in your life. And I believe there is no accident, okay? Everything is intentionally done by God. And you are listening to this message simply because God wants you to know, I have been calling you. I have been calling you. And I will give you a tip. When God is calling you, don't use call waiting. Okay? When God is calling you, answer the time God is calling you. Okay? Don't use call waiting. Okay? You know what? Okay, divert call, okay? Don't use call diverting. Don't use call hold, okay? When God is calling you, answer the phone. Kasi guys, wala tayong idea kung gaano katindi ang biyayang nagmumula sa Diyos na sakalang natin may experience sa loob ng kanyang kalooban kapag tayo ay nag-responde sa kanyang panawagan. God is calling you. Not because of anything you did. Maybe you are saying, I'm a pastor, I'm called by God. Sabi ng isa, paano naman ako? Ako ay hamak lang na artista sa Channel 7. Right? Okay, paano naman ako? Ako ay hamak lang ng... Okay, guys, okay? I believe God has a calling for every person. And we should not create our calling. Okay? Our calling is predetermined by God. What we have to do is to discover our calling. Discover natin, ano ba ang calling natin? Okay? Ano ba ang calling natin? At ang calling po natin, hindi ayon sa kung ano man ang ating nagawa para sa Kanya. No. Even before we were born, God wanted to call you. And God has chosen you. You have been set apart from many people in the land because God is pleasured every time. God is pleased every time He sees you. Sobrang special ka sa paningin ng Diyos, okay? So, write this, I'm called for God's purpose. Okay, number three. Number three, okay? God chose me and called me even before I was born. Okay? It pleased God in His kindness to choose me and call me even before I was born. What undeserved mercy. Before I shaped you in the womb, I knew all about you. Before you saw the light of day, I had holy plans for you, says God. Wow. Wow. Okay? Pinili ka ng Diyos bago ka palang ipanganak. And I want to say this, maybe your parents didn't plan you, but God planned you. Okay? Maybe you're saying, ako naman aksidente lang, okay? Gusto nga akong hindi mabuhay ng parents ko. Okay? But God is saying today, pinili kita dahil gusto kitang tawagin. Okay? God chose you and God called you even before you were born. Okay? And next slide po, okay? Next slide po. May ituturo ako sa inyo, okay? Every week, we will do something like this, okay? Every week, we will be having a memory verse. We are doing it in the small group, but we will be doing it also in our weekend service. So that there will be something in your heart which you can meditate day and night, okay? The verse is Isaiah 44:2. Now, this is the way we will memorize verses. You memorize through your ears, not through your eyes. Okay? If you are studying, the only way for you to memorize is by constantly hearing the words you want to memorize. You don't memorize by the eyes. You memorize by the ears. So what we will say, we will be saying this loudly so that it registers to our mind. Okay? It's very simple. Isaiah 44:2. I am your creator. You were in my care even before you were born. Isaiah 44:2. Now, okay? I have taught this in our small group. The way to memorize this is to mention the reference verse before and after the verse. Because many sa atin, alam ang verse, hindi alam kung saan galing. Okay? Okay. So, the way to memorize is you mention the reference verse, Isaiah 44:2. Before and after the verse. Okay? Can we do it? Okay? Let's do it. Okay? Isaiah, 1, 2, 3, go! Isaiah 44:2. I am your creator. You were in my care even before you were born. Isaiah 44:2. Okay, one more time, okay? Isaiah 44:2. I am your creator. You were in my care even before you were born. Isaiyah 44:2. Okay? Pwede mong paki-click lang before. Okay pa. Okay. Now, okay. Question, okay? Ano pong reference verse ng ating memory verse for the week? And what does Isaiah 44:2 say?
I am your creator,
even before you were born. Okay, let's do it. Okay, guys, God is gracious. Don't worry, okay? Even if you commit mistake in memorizing, God will never withdraw the calling yes for you, okay? So let's do it one more time, okay? Isaiah 44:2. Palakpakan niyo nga po kanyang mga sarili, okay? Okay. So, Isaiah 44:2. Okay? I want to add something to this verse 10, okay? Guys, makinig kayo sa akin. I just want to tell you that the verse say these things, okay? Number one, I am your creator. It means you are not an accident. And don't ever believe you are a product of an accident. Because if you believe you are an accident, you will be living your life as if it's an accident. Walang plano, walang direction, walang kahulugan, walang purpose. But believe God created you. You were created by God. And He is saying, I am your creator. He is affirming to your soul and spirit, ako ang lumikha sa'yo. Number two, God is saying, you were in my care. It means sobrang mahal ka ng creator mo. And maybe, ang tindi na nang nangyari sa buong buhay mo, but God is saying, you were in my care. You are deeply loved by me. If you are going to interpret the times and seasons by your own mindset, maybe you will think, hindi maganda ang buhay. But if you will borrow the eyes of God, you are going to see, matindi ang biyaya ng Diyos sa buhay mo. Matindi ang biyaya ng Diyos sa buhay mo. I am your creator. You were in my care even before you were born. And yung memory verse ng small group first week, Ephesians 2:10. Okay? It says something like this, okay? You are God's workmanship. You are created in Christ Jesus to do good works which God planned for you to do. Ephesians 2:10. And it's simply saying, ikaw ay obra maestra ng Diyos. Ikaw ay masterpiece ng Diyos. Ikaw ay likha ng Diyos. And don't ever look down on yourself. Kahit pa anong tindi ng sitwasyon, isipin mo, may tiwala ang Diyos sa'yo. Kaya niya ipinaparanas yung mga bagay na yan. You know what? The small group namin last time, pinag-uusapan namin na praise God kasi hindi natin kayang makita ang ating future ahead of time. Kasi kung kaya mo, baka mag-suicide tayo. Kasi baka ma-overwhelm ka sa makikita mo, okay? Magkakasakit pala ako ng ganung time, okay? Mababaon pala ako sa utak ng ganung time. Kaya ngayon, okay, yung palang anak ko magkakasakit, wala palang pan-tuition, exit pala ako, mawala pala akong trabaho. Buti na lang hindi ipinapakita ng Diyos. Kasi baka ma-overwhelm ka sa mga problema. But I wanna say this, hindi ka ba nagtataka na kahit na ang dami nang nangyari sa buong buhay mo, dito ka pa rin ngayon? Ano ibig sabihin nun? Mahal ka ng Diyos. Mahal ka ng Diyos. I am your creator, and you were in my care even before you were born, ang sabi ng Diyos sa'yo ngayon. So don't ever look down on yourself because God never looks down on you. He looks at you with pleasure. He looks at you with pride because God is your creator, and you were in His care even before you were born. Isaiah 44:2. Amen? Amen? Next tayo, okay? Number four, okay? First time ko pong gumamit ng notes sa buong buhay ko. So I'm hoping this helps me as well, okay? Ano po kaya? Praise God, okay? Okay? Ito, I like this, okay? My sins and my mistakes don't change my calling. I like this, okay? My sins and my mistakes don't change my calling. Okay, let's read this, okay? I thank Christ Jesus our Lord who has given me strength that He considered me trustworthy, appointing me or calling me to His service, even though I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and a violent man. I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. Guys, can you encircle the phrase, even though I was once, okay? Please encircle the phrase, even though I was once. And in this particular verse, we are talking about Paul. You know what? Si Paul po, okay? You know Paul. Paul is a character in the New Testament starting from the book of Acts. Okay? And yung pong kanyang history, you will never like him. Because he is a persecutor of people like us. Okay? He kills Christians, he persecutes Christians, he drags them out of their houses and stones them to death, okay? And there's one martyr named Stephen who were actually killed by the group with Paul in it. Okay? See, Paul is someone na makasalanan, mamamatay tao, terorista ng mga panahon nila. But, hindi hinayaan ng Diyos na maging sagabal ang mga bagay na nangyari sa buhay natin, ginawa natin sa buhay natin, na kahit may mga bagay kang nagawa na hanggang ngayon, pinagsisisihan mo pa, ang sabi ng Diyos, hindi yan hadlang para tawagin kita. Hindi hadlang ang ating kakulangan para ating makita na ang Diyos ay may panawagan sa buhay natin. Gaya ni Paul, he was once a blasphemer. A persecutor, a violent person, but God appointed him to service. And guys, I want you to consider this, even though I was once, and I want you to personalize the message, even though you were also once like that, God wants to open a calling in your life. Amen? Even though I was once born against, okay? Even though I was once a cheater, a liar, okay? A drug addict or whatever, a drug lord or a corrupt person or a vile person or whatever. Okay, you can put whatever in it. Okay? What is sugarol? Okay, you are sugar baby, okay? A gambler, okay? Sugar baby, okay? Okay? You are rolling sugar, okay? So even if there are things in your life, a bad history you are never going to be proud of, still God wants to call you. And your sins and your mistakes will never change the calling of God in your life. Guys, ang goal ko this morning is for you to see may panawagan ka. May panawagan ka. At sa 60 linggo na dito na, pag-uusapan natin, ano ba yung mga panawagan natin? We will be discovering what kind of calling we have in Christ Jesus. Ito po, intro, then we will open next week. Pero ngayon, gusto ko maunawaan mo na kahit na ikaw, okay, maybe you are coming here for the first time, or maybe you're coming here several times, and you don't understand, guys, I want you to get it by heart. God wants to give you a second chance, so you can accomplish the calling of God in your life. Mahal ka ng Panginoon. Sobrang mahal ka ng Panginoon. At gagawin ng Diyos ang lahat. God will do whatever it takes for you to be aligned to His calling so that at the end of a time, He will say, "Well done, my loving and my faithful servant." Ang goal ko po sa buong buhay ko, matulungan po tayong lahat. Ang goal ko po sa buong buhay ko is tayo po yung magkaisa para po magawa natin ng panawagan ng Diyos, okay? Alam nyo, okay? Ang iba kasi, pagka sinabi panawagan, they interpret it, gusto maging pastor, okay? At yun ang thinking ng mga tao, eh. Guys, I wanna say this, okay? Hindi tayo lahat magiging pastor. I pray lahat tayo maging pastor. But for some people, iba talaga, unique ang panawagan mo. At don't ever think na ang iyong office ay ang iyong panawagan. No. Your career is not the same as your calling. Sometimes, pareha sila, but most of the time, hindi. Okay, right now I have two vocations. Okay, I am an accountant in the morning and I am a pastor in the evening. Ang iba sa inyo sa umaga, dispatchadora, sa gabi naman ay bongga. Okay? Ang iba sa inyo, chef sa umaga, pastor sa gabi, di ba? Ang ibig sabihin is, don't ever think na ang inyong panawagan ay ang inyong trabaho. Because calling is permanent. Please click, okay? Calling is permanent. And guys, if you are changing job once in a while, it means your calling is not your job. Because you can change job anytime. Amen? But God will never change or withdraw the calling you have. Okay? Ang ibig ko po sabihin dito ay kahit na ikaw ay nangangamuhan, okay? Tayo ay mga empleyado. You can still do the calling of God in your life. Kahit ikaw ay assistant sa isang kumpanya or accountant or secretary or draftsman or waiter or bartender or barista or chef or whatever, okay? Kahit na ano pa man ang inyong career na napili ngayon, okay? Your calling is intact at hindi yan binabago ng Diyos. What we have to do in the next 6 weeks, we will discover ano ba yung calling nito sa atin? Ano ba ang calling ng Diyos sa atin? Okay? At guys, look at me, okay? I will say this. Can you invite someone next week? Because what we will be studying will change your life and it will change their life. If I know a message more important than this, I will not waste your time. I will not waste my time. But I believe to start this year right, we have to be aligned with what God is calling us into. There's no way. There's no way. We have to be aligned with what God is calling us into. And for us to be of help to someone else's life, maybe you know a friend who thinks there is no direction in life, he is a candidate to be blessed by God in this service. Maybe you have a friend na parang nabobore na sa buhay, okay? Tiyatama na sa buhay, okay? Ayaw na maglinggo kasi work na naman, okay? Ayaw na. Because for him, life is getting up in the morning, taking 3 meals in the day, and sleeping at night. And if you know that kind of person, tell him, our church is having a series which can help you live the life you want it to live it with. Okay? So, would you care for someone and invite him next week and all together we will be steady. Sino po nabe-bless na ngayon pa lang sa preaching ngayon? Okay? Okay? And next week, you'll be having something like this. Okay? So guys, sabi ito, God's gifts and His calling are irrevocable. Okay? God's calling and God's gift can never be withdrawn. And maybe, while you are doing your calling, you make mistake. God will never withdraw the calling God has for your life. Even if you make mistakes, yes, sometimes it will delay you from accomplishing the calling, but God is gracious. He will never withdraw the calling in your life. Agree? Okay? Number six, my calling is connected to others. This is very important. Alam niyo po si Pastor, okay? I really believe in this song, okay? Tama yung kanta na ating nadinig simula ng mga bata pa tayo. Walang sino mang nabubuhay para sa sarili. Okay, guys, pwede bang help me? Okay? Walang sino mang nabubuhay para sa sarili. Okay. Guys, that song is a gold, for me, is a treasure. Tama ang kantang yan. And actually, your calling is connected to others. What I'm saying is, it will be difficult for you to accomplish your calling by yourself. You have to be connected with others. It says here, we are all one body. Please encircle, highlight the word one body. We have the same spirit. And seek the same spirit, and we have all been called to the same glorious future hope. Holy brothers and sisters, you share in the heavenly calling. Now, guys, listen to me, okay? Okay? What we will be doing in the next 6 weeks, 70% of this will be done in and through small groups. Okay? Because I have already told our small groups to include this as part of our curriculum. In fact, kung kayo po ay naging part ng small group, sino po nag-purpose-driven life dito na small groups, okay? Sino po, pakiraise nga po ng hands, okay lang yung nagpa-purpose-driven life, okay? Praise ka lang, kaya, okay? 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 Now, okay? For you to better understand what I am telling you, be part of a small group. If you are not a part of a small group, Rojan is there smiling, please wave. Okay? And she will be glad to enroll you to any small group. Okay? Now, if you want to start a group, You can start. You can do so. Okay? Don't worry. You will be given with many tools for you to start a group. Okay? So either you become part of a group or you start a group. It's the same thing. Just approach Rogen and we will be very happy to invite you to be part of SMOG. Because you can never accomplish the calling apart from the Christians around you. Impossible po. Impossible po. When we go on with the next topics, you will understand imposibleng ma-accomplish mo ang calling mo ng nag-iisa. Okay? No man is an island. Okay? You have to be part of a community. Because calling and community go together. You cannot accomplish your calling by yourself. Impossible yan. Impossible yan. Your calling is connected to others. Next click po. Okay? Number 7. God empowers me to do what He calls me. Okay? With this in mind, we constantly pray for you that our God may make you worthy of His calling and that by His power, He may bring to fruition your every desire for goodness and your every deed prompted by faith. The one who calls you is faithful and He will do it. Guys, this is a very important verse, okay? Maybe you're saying, yes, God is calling me, but paano? Paano? Have you heard of the verse, the battle is of the Lord's? Have you heard of the verse, I will give you strength. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Okay? Have you heard the verse, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me? Have you heard of the verse? Okay. Okay. So guys, don't ever worry because God is going to give everything you need in life and in godliness for you to accomplish the calling of God. When you say yes to God, God will empower you and God will provide for you. In fact, I want to say this, maybe your provision is delayed because you have not said yes. I will say this again, okay? Baka po ang totoong dahilan, kaya ang provision ay delay dahil hindi pa tayo nagsusworn in. Baka hindi pa tayo nagpapa-enroll. Baka hindi pa tayo nagpapalista. Baka hindi pa natin kiniklik yung answer key. Maybe today, we can change our mind. Maybe today, we can say, Lord, I am saying yes to you now. And lahat ng tinawag ng Diyos, siya ang bahala. When God gives a vision, He will give the provision. When God gives, if it is His will, it is His way. Alam niyo po, ako po, I will share one story and I'm about to end. When I started this church, actually po sa totoo lang, hindi naman pinakita sa akin ng Diyos kung ano mangyayari. Okay? Hindi pinakita ng Diyos na okay, Rich, you will see yourself in January 5 teaching this verse. No. In fact, sa totoo lang, nangangapa si Pastor. Noong time na yon, nagkaroon kami ng problema matindi, okay? Nawalan ako ng trabaho, nagkaroon ng problema yung company, nagkaroon kami problema mag-asawa, yung kotse ko malaki, okay? Kinuha ng bangko. Okay, I wasn't able to fulfill some of my obligations. Pero iniisip ko, imposible kang tatawagin ng Diyos nang wala siyang baon para sa iyo. Iniisip ko 'yan. At alam mo sa totoo lang, kung ipinakita lang ng Diyos sa akin kung ano mangyayari in the future, either I am continuing or I will stop. 'Di ba? Kung sakaling ipapakita ng Diyos sa'yo kung ano mangyayari sa future, either you will continue or you will stop. The good thing is, hindi ipapakita ng Diyos sa'yo because we have to live by faith and not by sight. Ang kailangan gawin ngayon is for you to hold your spines together and say, Lord, here I am. Use me. And I don't know kung kaya ko, pero naniniwala ako na kaya ng Diyos na siyang tumawag sa akin. Kaya ng Diyos yan. Okay? Alam niyo sa totoo lang, ang iba sa atin, okay? Ang iba sa atin, they are waiting for perfect conditions before you start. Okay? Ako po, you invite, okay? Sige kapatid, I will join your church kapag ka wala na akong problema. Okay? Di ba? Kailan ka mag-aasawa? Kapag ka okay na kami, pag may ipon na ako. Yan, ha? Okay, okay lang ka maging small group ay kapag ka okay na yung aking condition sa puso ko. Yan, okay, ha? Okay lang ka mag-tights ay kapag ka wala na akong utang. Okay, di ba? Di ba? Guys, and I will not blame you because our human tendency is for us to wait for perfect conditions when to start something. But, ang sabi ng Bible, Ecclesiastes, okay? If you wait for perfect conditions, you will never get anything done. Powerful verse in the Bible. If you will wait for perfect conditions, you will never get anything done. So, ang gawin mo ngayon, hindi mo alam kung anong mangyayari, yes, Lord ka lang, kasi ang Diyos ang tumawag sa'yo, bahala siyang mag-provide. Imposibleng maging army ka ng Diyos na hindi ka bibigyan ng bala. Amen? So, you don't know, you don't know what the future holds, but you know who holds your future. You don't know what is up to your life, but you know who holds your life and who is in control. So guys, today, let's decide. Ako po, I am deciding. Okay? I am making a covenant with God today. Again, in my life. Okay? Panginoon, kung saan mo mang gustong dalhin ang buhay ko, dalhin mo lang. Basta kasama kita. Okay? Yun lang ang mahalaga eh. Hindi mahalaga kung may trabaho ka, hindi mahalaga kung wala kang trabaho. Ang mahalaga kung kasama mo ang Diyos, kayang-kaya mo yan, kapatid. Yun lang ang mahalaga. Okay? Hindi mahalaga kung nabunosan ka. Hindi mahalaga kung sumasahod ka ng on time. Ang mahalaga kung kasama mo ba ang presensya ng Panginoon sa lahat ng lakad ng buhay mo, yun ang pinakamahalaga. Kasi kapag, if God is with you, who can be against you? Amen? So guys, God empowers you to do your calling. Huwag kang mag-aala. Last part, okay? I like this. Guys, okay, I will be teaching you an acrostics, okay? So, learn. How to learn, okay? How to learn things, okay? Learn. It's not there, so you may want to write that down, okay? Learn. Number one, listen to God's word every day. Okay? Listen to God's word every day, okay? Number two, enlist friends who challenge me. Be part of a community. Be part of a small group. Because you will never learn things unless you are part of a small group. Okay? Isa pa, sabihin ko pa, isa pa, okay? Guys, ito, that's why I want to encourage my leaders to lead small group. Because you know, church, when you become part of a small group, your learning is like this. But when you lead a small group, your learning will be like this. Because the most powerful thing ever in learning is passing it away. When you give things away, you learn faster. So I want to encourage those my friends, lead a small group. If you want to grow faster, lead a small group. Enlist friends who can challenge you. Who can challenge you? Okay, yung mga kaibigan yung ano? I will say okay. Ask questions and accept correction. Okay? Remember and reinforce what I learned. Don't just limit your learning inside the four corners of this room. What you have learned in this room, reinforce them outside. I am your creator. Hindi na alam, okay? I am your creator. You were in my care, okay? Isaiah 44:2. I am your creator. You were in my care even before you were born. So don't limit learning inside the four corners of this room. Go outside and reinforce what you are learning. Apply it in every detail of your life. In that way, you will be growing faster. Agree? Then do it now. Do it now. Don't wait for perfect conditions. Do it now. Do it now. Amen? Then lastly, number 8, then we will be ending na. Okay? Lastly, and you would like this, there is a price for living out my calling. May pagpaparang naghihintay whenever we live out our calling. Guys, ako po'y kinikilabutan as I say this kasi I really like this, okay? I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Live the kind of life that pleases God who calls you to share in His own kingdom and glory. Alam niyo po, human tendency, wala kang pakialam hanggat wala kang nakukuha ang kapalit. Okay, di ba? Okay, guys, ears with me, okay? Human tendency, kahit pa ang ganda-ganda ng binabanggit ng mga tao ni Pastor, pero kung wala kang concrete na benepisyo, sometimes half-hearted ka lang eh. Pero paano guys kung ngayong araw, sinasabi ng Diyos sa'yo na masyado kang focus sa sakripisyo mo. Hindi mo ba alam kung anong benepisyo meron ka kapag ka akong kasama mo? May pagpapalang hatid kapag ka lumalakad tayo sa kanyang panawagan. Agree? May pagpapalang hatid kapag lumalakad tayo sa panawagan niya. Tayo po tayong lahat and I want you to think about this, okay? I put it in the last so that this will be the last thing you will in the mind before I minister. Alam niyo po, doon po sa seminar na ina-attendan ko, I was asked by the mentor, no? By the teacher. Sabi niya sa akin, and I will be asking this again to you, please focus. If you would know what you will be gaining from God, would you have reservation? Tanong niya ako. Richelle, kung alam mo kaya kung ano yung mga pagpapalang ibibigay sa'yo ng Diyos, sa tingin mo, may mga reservation ka pa kaya? May mga reservation ka pa kaya? Sabi ko, of course, I won't have. Eh, ang problema lang naman, hindi ko alam kung meron nga eh. And faith comes in. Alam niyo po ang problema sa atin? Hindi tayo lubos ang makapagtiwala sa Panginoon. Kaya takot tayong ibigay sa Diyos lahat. Ngayong araw, gusto kong maunawaan ninyong lahat. There is a price every time you live the calling of God. There is a price, kapatid. There's a price, kapatid. And I want to pray for you. Pwede po bang let's take a moment of silence. I'll be praying. And this is the last part of the subject today. Let's close our eyes and let's pray. Lord, open our hearts today, God. Buksan mo ang mga puso namin ngayon. Dahil, Panginoon, pagod na kami sa nakikita ng aming mga mata. Nakakasakit na ang nakikita ng aming mga mata. And I know, Panginoon, mahal mo kami. Mahal mo ang bawat isa sa amin. At nararamdaman mong napapagod na ang ilan sa amin. Nakikita mo nahihirapan na ang ilan sa amin. Panginoon, tulungan mo ang bawat isa na makita galing sa iyong mga mata na mayroong kang pangako, plano sa buhay naming lahat. Na we are not here just to enjoy. We are here to be blessed by God and to be a blessing to your name and to someone else. Kaya Panginoon, by the power of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name, I am releasing that kind of anointing which makes us see the things the way you are seeing it. Lord, first, thank you because you are calling us. You could have called someone else, but Lord, you have called us to your marvelous light. I pray, Panginoon, na tulungan mo ako at ang mga kapatid ko na magawa ang aming panawagan sa iyo. Panginoon, tulungan mo kaming magtiwala sa iyo. Tulungan mo kaming kumapit sa iyo. Turuan mo kaming sumamba sa iyo. God, we give the highest praise, we give the highest glory. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen.